Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The attack yesterday on the Hawaiian Islands has caused severe damage to America's naval and military forces. I regret to tell you that very many American lives have been lost. With confidence in our armed forces, with the unbounding determination of our people, we will gain the inevitable triumph, so help us God.
That is frangipani.
Ah, what a color!
You will find many more beautiful flowers out here. Oh. Et je suis le café. C'est tout.
I'm finding out.
Would you like some cognac?
I'd love some.
Comes once a month. The ladies, the wives of the planters, often go to Australia in the hot months. It can get very hot here.
Oh, it can get hot in Arkansas too.
Ah, yes. I have many books here. André Gide, Marcel Proust. Did you study French in school?
Oh, yes.
Then you can read French.
No, but I can conjugate a few verbs. Oh, he must read an awful lot.
Out here, one becomes hungry to learn everything, not to miss anything, not to let anything good pass by.
Yes.
One waits so long for what is good. And when at last it comes, one cannot risk to lose. So, one must speak and act quickly, even if it is almost foolish to be so quick. I know it has only been 2 weeks. A dinner at your officers' club, do you remember?
Oh, yes.
That is the way things happen sometimes, isn't it, Millie?
Yes, it is, Mew.
Some enchanted evening, you may see a stranger. You may see a stranger across a crowded room, and somehow to leave you.
Someone may be laughing. You may hear laughing across a crowded room. And night after night, as strange as it seems, the sound of a laughter will sing.
Thank you.
Professor. These beautiful skirts were made by myself, the professor here, and three other CBs in half the time it takes your native workers to make them. See? No stretch. Look them over, sweaty pie, and give me your price.
Hey! Look at that shirt! Take it up with the manager! Hey, big dealer! Hey, Luther! Billis!
What can I do for you, my boy? What seems to be the trouble?
Look at that shirt!
Uh-huh. The Billis Laundry is not responsible for minor burns and tears. So what do you say, Sweatso? What am I offering?
All and so. Yes, that's mighty nice work.
Yeah, that's 25. You could probably sell these to the chumps for $5 or $6 a piece. Now, I'll let you have the whole bunch for, say, $80.
I give you, $10.
What?
Not enough?
Damn well right, not enough.
Then you damn well keep.
Now look here, dragon lady, I didn't come. Oh. Hey, what's that you got there? Boar's tooth bracelet? Where'd you get that?
Oh. Over there on Valley High?
You like?
Oh. Hey, come here. You know what that is? That's a bracelet made out of a single boar's tooth. They cut the tooth out of the boar's mouth in a big ceremonial over there on Valley High. Oh, there ain't a souvenir in the South Pacific you'd pick up as valuable as this. What do you want for it, Mary?
$100?
That's cheap. I thought it'd be more.
I don't see how she can turn it up now.
I make you a special offer, big dealer. I trade you boar's tooth bracelet for all grass scarves.
Yeah, that's a deal.
Not too fast. It's no deal till you throw in something for good luck.
Oh, okay. What do you want me to throw in?
$100. Good luck.
You don't run into these things every day. They're scarce as hen's teeth.
They're bigger too.
Damn Valley High. Why does it gotta be off limits? You can get everything over there. Shrunken heads, bracelets, old ivory,
French women.
Hey, knock it off. I'm talking about souvenirs.
So speed.
We gotta get a boat and get over there. I'm feeling held down again. I gotta take a trip.
But only officers can sign off boats.
I'll get a boat, all right. I'll latch on to some officer who's got an imagination. Who'd like to see that boar's tooth ceremonial as much as I would? Hey, it's a pimp of a ceremonial! Dancing, drinking, everything!
You big phony! We all know why you want to go to Valley High.
Oh yeah, why?
Because the French planners put all their daughters there when they heard the GIs were coming. That's why. It ain't boar's teeth. It's women.
It is boar's teeth! And women!
There is nothing you can name that is anything like a day.
Yes, Miss Forbush?
Have you done as you promised?
Yes, Miss Forbush. I did it all last night. Oh, no, you don't have to open it now. You don't...
Oh, you do beautiful work, Luther. You've even done the pleats in my shorts.
Well, pleats ain't hard.
Pleats are very hard. How do you do such delicate work at night, in the dark?
There was a moon.
There was a moon!
How much, Luther?
Oh, no, not from you.
I guess I'm just about the luckiest nurse on the island to have found you. Gosh, you're a treasure. Goodbye, Luther. Hot 2, 3, 4. Hot 2, 3, 4.
She's a nice little girl, but some of those nurses, the officers can have them.
They got them.
No, they can have them.
So suppose the day ain't bright.
Walk a million people across. Where's Anna Santa Claus?
It's a waste of time to worry over things that they have not.
Be there before the things they've got.
Thinks like a day. Nothing acts like a day. Or attracts like a day. There ain't a thing that's wrong with any man here. They can't be cured by putting them near. A girly, womanly, female, feminine
Something calling? Listen.
think I hear something.
Shut your big fat mouth!
Hear, boys? Some people live on a lonely island. Lost in the middle of a foggy sea. Those people long for another
over there. But there is something else that goes on over there. The ceremony.
ceremonial of the boar's tooth. After they kill the boar, they pass around some of that coconut liquor, and all the girls dance around with just skirts on, and everybody gets to know everybody pretty well. Little tribal ceremonial, primitive but astonishing. And I thought with you being up in the shooting war for so long without getting any recreation, thought you might be interested.
I am. But right now I've got to report to the commander.
Professor, take the lieutenant up in the truck.
Professor.
Yeah, it's because he went to college. You go to college?
Yes, I did.
Where?
Place in Jersey.
Where, Rutgers?
No, Princeton.
Oh, hey, folks got money, lieutenant. Oh, don't be ashamed of it, we understand. Hey, maybe you'd like to hear the professor talk some language. What do you want, Grecian? Latin? Hey, give me some Latin. Yeah. Rectum vives lacini.
Oh!
Ain't that beautiful?
Neque altum semper progendo dum procellus.
Okay, Lieutenant, what did he say?
I'm afraid I haven't the slightest idea.
What's the matter? Didn't you graduate? All right, take the lieutenant up to the buildings.
Aye, aye.
He's never going to make captain.
There she is, sir.
You are causing an economic revolution on this island. These French planters can't find a native to pick a coconut or milk a cow because you're paying them 10 times as much to make these ridiculous grass skirts.
French planters, stingy bastards!
Sir, may I make a suggestion, sir?
Who are you?
Billis, sir. Luther Billis. The natives can now go back to work on the farms. The demand for grass skirts can now be met by us Seabees.
Pressman, you mean to tell me the Seabees of the United States Navy...
Hey, we don't like the idea, sir. We'll just drop it right here, sir. Just say the word. Just pretend I never brought it up.
Luther Billis.
Yes, sir!
Nothing. Just making a mental note.
I want to be sure not to forget your name.
I want you to pick up every scrap of this paraphernalia now. And for the last time, carry it way down there, beyond that fence. Off Navy property.
All right, come on, let's get the stuff and move it down over there off that fence. Let's go.
All right, take it way down there. Off Navy property.
You go too.
Okay, Lieutenant. Thank you.
Lieutenant, who are you anyway?
Lieutenant Joseph Cable, sir. Just flew off that PBY.
A joyride?
No, sir. Orders.
A Marine under orders to me?
Yes, sir.
I'm Captain Bracken.
How do you do, sir?
This is my executive officer, Commander Harbison. Well, what's it all about?
Well, sir, my colonel feels that all these islands are in danger because none of us has been getting any first-hand intelligence. What we need to set up is a coast watch.
Coast watch?
Yes, sir, a man hiding out on one of these Japanese-held islands with a radio, where he can watch the Japanese ships as they start down the bottleneck. Down this way.
What do you think, Bill?
Sir, our pilots could do a hell of a lot to Japanese convoys with information like that.
You'd have to sneak this man ashore at night from a submarine.
Yes, sir.
Who's going to do it?
Well, sir, I've been elected.
You've got quite an assignment, son.
How long do you think you'd last there, sending out messages before the enemy found you?
I think I'd be okay, sir. If I could take a man with me who really knew the country. Headquarters has found out about a French civilian here who used to have a plantation on Marie Louise Island.
Marie Louise? That's a good spot. It's right on the bottom.
What's this Frenchman's name?
Emile Debec.
Meet me in my office in about half an hour, Cable.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Bill. Maybe we'll get into this war yet.
Thank you.
Looks like an old orange painted with shoe polish.
That's what it is.
Take it back and tell him to try again. When I order a dried up human head, I want a human head dried up. Miss Spade, here it comes. Don't change your expression, Lieutenant. Just act like we're talking casual. I got the boat.
What boat?
Keep your voice down. Just keep walking down the company street. I signed out a boat in your name. We're shutting off for Valley High in 45 minutes.
No, we're not. I've got to report to the island commander.
But, Lieutenant, what are you doing to me? I signed the boat out in your name. So.
Well, then you're just the man to go back and cancel it. Just forget the whole thing, okay?
Lieutenant! Lieutenant, you and me are going on a boat trip, whether you like it or not!
Captain, damn, let me go!
Cable, we've got some dope on your Frenchman. Marie Louise Island. Came down here 16 years ago. Lived with a Polynesian woman for about 5 years. 2 children by her. She died. Now, here's one thing we've got to clear up. Seems you left France in a hurry. Killed a guy. What do you think about that?
Might be a handyman to have around.
Hey, Cable. Good, send her in. No, we don't have time for her to change into her uniform. Just tell her to come in. Come in, Miss Forbush.
Captain Brackett, please excuse the way I look.
You look fine. May I present Commander Hardison?
I have the pleasure of meeting Miss Forbush twice a week. We served together on the GI Entertainment Committee.
May I also present Lieutenant Joseph Cable. Miss Forbush. Sit down, Miss Forbush. So, how's the Thanksgiving entertainment coming along?
Oh, very well. Thank you, sir. We practice whenever we get a chance.
About a week ago, you had lunch with a French planter, Emile Debec.
Yes, sir.
What do you know about him?
What do I know about him?
That's right.
Well, we met at the officers' club dance. He was there and I met him. We had lunch later
yes.
that day.
Now, what kind of a man is he?
Oh, he's very nice. He's kind and attractive. I guess I just don't know what you want to know, sir.
Miss Forbush, Captain Brackett wants to know, did you discuss politics?
No, sir.
Would you have discussed politics, Commander? Now, what we're specifically interested in is, when these fellas come out from France, it's generally because they've had some trouble. Has he ever told you anything about that? What do you know about his family?
Oh, he has no family. No wife, nobody.
He hasn't any children?
No, sir.
And you say he's never told you why he left France?
Yes, sir. He left France because he killed a man.
Well, did he tell you why?
No. But he would if I asked him.
Well, Miss Forbush, that's exactly what we'd like to have you do. Find out as much as you can about him, his background, his opinions, and why he killed this man in France.
In other words, you want me to spy on him?
Well, I'm afraid it is something like that.
Why? Do you suspect him of anything?
No. It's just we don't know very much about him. Will you help us, Miss Forbush?
I'll try, sir.
Thank you. You may go now if you wish.
I don't know very much about him, do I?
He has kept a few secrets from her, hasn't he?
Well, you don't spray a couple of Polynesian kids on a woman right off the bat.
I'm afraid we're not going to get much out of her. She's obviously in love with him.
I find that hard to believe, sir. They tell me he's a middle-aged man.
Cable! It's a common mistake for boys of your age and athletic ability to underestimate men who have reached their maturity.
Sir, I didn't mean...
Young women frequently find grown men attractive, strange as that may seem to you. I myself am over 50. I'm a bachelor and Cable. I do not by any means consider myself rude. What's the matter, Bill?
Nothing, evidently.
Okay, Cable, see you, chow. You play bridge?
Yes, sir.
You got any money?
Yes, sir.
I'll take it away from you.
Yes, sir.
What makes you so damn sure this mission won't work out?
Marie Louise Island is 24 miles long, 3 miles wide. Now, let's say every time they sent out a message, they moved to another hill. They could last about a week.
Of course, it would be worth it if it were the right week. With decent information, our side might just get moving. Operation Alligator might get off its can.
Here it is, sir.
See you at Chow, Bill.
See you at Chow.
Got the address right?
I think so, sir. This is Amelia Fortuna, 325 Euclid Avenue, Shaker Heights, Cleveland, Ohio.
That's right. I'll pack it myself.
Yes, sir.
This man came to our town. Though my father said he was good, I thought he was bad. I was young. He attracted all the mean and cruel people to him. Soon he was running our town. He could do anything, take anything. I did not like that. I was young. I stood up in the town square and I made a speech calling for everyone to stand with me against this man.
What did they do?
They walked away.
Why?
Because they saw him standing behind me. I turned to him and he said to me, "I'm going to kill you now." We fought. I was never so strong. I knocked him to the ground and as he fell, his head hit a stone. I ran to the waterfront and I joined a cargo boat. I didn't even know where I was going. I stepped off that boat into another world.
where I am now, and where I want to stay. Nelly, will you marry me? Our lives are so short, and the time I have spent with you is so precious to me. Have you been thinking?
Yes, Emil, I have been thinking.
Born on the opposite sides of the sea, we are as different as people can be.
It's true.
Land and
What should I do now?
The
back to Mount Fit tonight?
No. Take a couple of days off and unwind.
Unwind?
Sure. Take a boat. Go fishing.
But you're just a kid. How did Bloody Mary get a kid like you to... I don't get it. Bloody Mary's your mother? She didn't tell me. It's the boat.
My eyes look down at your lovely face. I'm in love with the wonderful guy.
champagne. Oh, here, you have some too. It's such a waste.
Wait, here's another bottle.
Thank you.
trouble with the mimeograph, so I'm going to announce the next act. It's a weightlifting exhibition by Marine Staff Sergeant Kevin Barr.
All right, everyone, let's go.
Woo! It's wonderful. It's...
You don't have to work. I work for you.
Oh, wow.
here be together. Walk through woods, swim and sea, sing, dance, talk happy. No, think about Philadelphia. It's no good. Think about beautiful things and make love all day long. You like, you buy, happy talking, talking, happy talk. Talk about things you'd like to do. You gotta have a dream. If you don't have a dream, how you gonna have a dream come true? Talk about a moon floating in the sky, looking like a lily on the lake. Talk about a bird learning how to fly, making all the music it can make. Happy talking, talking, happy talk. Talk about things you'd like to do. You gotta have a dream. If you don't have a dream, how you gonna have a dream come true?
Thank you.
our side has been having the hell beat out of it in two hemispheres. We're not going to get to go home until the situation is reversed. Might take a long time before we can get any kind of big operation underway. So it's things like this, well, like this show tonight, to keep us going. Now, I know I'm not generally considered a sentimental type. Once or twice, I understand I've been referred to as old iron belt. Well, I resent that very much, because I had chosen that as my private name for our executive officer, Commander Harbison. Take a bow, Commander. I want you to know that both old Iron Belly sat here tonight and had a hell of a good time. We'd just like to thank that committee of nurses and CBs, well, for making these costumes out of rope and mosquito net, comic books, and for thinking up these jokes and these grand songs. And so I'd just like to say on this Thanksgiving Day, to all of them, from all of us, thank you. Commander Harbison to announce the next act, which will be the grand finale of this year's Thanksgiving entertainment. Commander?
Our next and last song will be sung by Bosun Butch Forbush and by that siren of the Coral Sea, the gorgeous, voluptuous, and petite Mademoiselle Lutheria Billis?
Come on, Bill!
Where she's narrow,
Mom! I beg your pardon!
Sorry, ladies.
Phyllis, you really are a honey bun. The flowers are so beautiful. I needed someone to think of me tonight. Thank you so much.
Miss Forbush, I would like you to know that I consider you the most wonderful woman in the entire world, including the fact that you're an officer and all. And I can't go on being such a heel as to make you think I thought of giving you those flowers.
But you did give them to me, Luke. I'm standing right there.
Here's the card that came with them. Are you okay, Miss Forbush? Well, I'll be waiting around the area here in case you need me. Just sing out.
Diplomatic difficulties with France.
Joe Cable, who let you out of the hospital?
Joe.
You're trying to get back to Valley Heights, that little girl you told me about.
Leah. I have just seen her for the last time. I love her, and yet I just heard myself say I can't marry her. The way you look right now is the same way my mother would look. Well, damn it to hell, why? Why do you look so shocked? What is the difference if her hair is blonde and curly or black and straight?
Joe, you can have her if you want to. They say it doesn't work.
Hell of a chance Leah and I would have had. In one of those gray stone and timber houses down on the main line. Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Cable entertained last night at a housewarming. Nobody came.
Oh, Joe, you're just far from home, that's all. We're both so far from home.
Nellie, I must see you.
Leah, I can't.
Will you
please.
Excuse us, Lieutenant Cable?
No. Joe, please stay. You might as well hear what I'm about to say because you just said it yourself. Emil, before I say this, you've got to believe one thing. And that is, I do love you.
No,
wait. I've got to say this fast because if I don't, I'll never say it. I can't marry you.
No. Because of my children?
No. No. Not because of the children. They're sweet.
It is their Polynesian mother, then. Their mother and I.
Yes. I can't help it. It's not like I can give you a reason, Emil. There is no reason. It's emotional. It's something that's born inside of me.
It is not. I do not believe it is born in you.
Then how come I feel the way I do? All I know is I can't help it. I can't help it. Please, Joe, explain the way we feel. I am sorry, Emil.
Nellie! Nellie! What makes her talk like that? Why do you have this feeling, you and she? I do not believe it is born in you. I do not believe it.
It is not born in you. It happens after you're born. You've got to be taught to hate and fear. You've got to be taught from year to year. It's got to be drummed in your dear little ear. You've got to be carefully taught. You've got to be taught to be afraid of people whose eyes are oddly made and people whose skin is a different shade. You've got to be carefully taught. You've got to be taught before it's too late, before you are 6 or 7 or 8, to hate all the people your relatives hate. You've got to be carefully taught. You've got to be carefully taught.
This is just the kind of ugliness I was running away from. Now it has followed me all this way, all these years. Now, it has found me.
I was cheated before, and I'm cheated again by a mean little world of mean little men. And the one chance for me is this life I know best, to be here on an island and to hell with the rest. I will cling to this island like a tree or a stone. I will cling to this island and be free and alone.
Yes, sir. If I get out of this thing alive, I am not going back there. I'm coming right back here. Because all I care about is here.
When all you care about is here, this is a good place to be. Thereabout has been taken away. There is no place. I was so close to it. So close.
Japanese carriers, cargo boats, cruise ships.
Big game. When I go up, what side shall I?
The south side.
Why?
There's a rock there, cove. I've sailed in behind these rocks many times.
Could a submarine get in between these rocks without being detected?
Yes, if you know the channel.
After I land, what will I do?
You will get in touch with my friends. They will hide us in the hills.
Us? You're going with me?
Of course. You are too young to be alone. Come on, let's go find Captain Brackett.
Let's wait till this old bastard Brackett hears this. He's gonna jump out of his skin.
I would like to see this kind of jump.
Spotted us and made that hit. That's when Luther, this fell here, that's when he
$600,000.
$600,000?
What the hell are you so happy about?
Well, sir, I was just thinking about my uncle. Remember my uncle I was telling you about? He used to tell my old man I'd never be worth a dime. Then his lousy slot machines, can you believe?
What the hell did you do this anyway for, Willis? What would make a man do a thing like this?
Well, sir, a fella has to keep moving. You know, you get kind of held down. And if you're itching to take a trip to pick up a few souvenirs, you gotta kind of horn in. If you get the picture.
How the hell did you know about this anyway?
Well, I didn't know about it exactly. It's just that when I heard Lieutenant Cable talking to that Frenchman, DeBec, I knew something was in the air. A project. And that's what I like, Captain. Projects. Don't you? Willis, you have broken every regulation in the book. By God, Captain Bracken and I are gonna throw it at you.
Sir, Command Sergeant. My co-pilot watches this whole thing, you know. Well, he thinks this fellow Bill is down there in our boat with all those planes above him caused a kind of diversionary action. While all those Japanese were busy shooting those planes at Billis, on the other side of the island, that submarine was sliding into that little cove and passing the Frenchman and Joe Cable in behind those rocks.
What the hell do you want me to do? Give this guy a bronze star?
Oh, you don't have to get me a bronze star, Captain.
But I could use a little freedom. A little room to swing around in, if you get the idea. If you get my picture.
Get out of here.
That's the place with coconuts in
the middle. Get the hell out of here!
Yes, sir!
Well, Iron Belly, what would have you done?
I'd have thrown him in the brig. I will, too, if I get the ghost of a chance.
So we are here. This is our first chance to send news to you. We have made contact with former friends of mine. We have set up quarters in a mango tree. No room but the lovely deep. First the weather. Great clouds over Bougainville, the treasuries, Choiseul, and New Georgia. We expect rain in this region from 9 o'clock to 2 o'clock. Oh, my friend Joe corrects me. Oh, 900 to 1400. And now, our military expert, Joe.
All you Navy, Marine, and Army pilots, write this down. Surface craft. 19 troop barges heading down the bottom. Speed, about 11 knots. Off to Castanica about 2,100 hours tonight. Escorted by heavy warships. There ought to be some way to knock off the POVs. As for aircraft, there's little indication of activity at the moment. 22 bombers, beds. Went by at 0600 headed southwest. With a fighter escort, not heavy.
Oh boy, ship, where you going?
Well, I don't want to miss this takeoff. We'll be going out ways tonight, ways!
Sit down, Bill. Here.
Oh, thanks.
You know what I like? Projects.
Today they just kept mentioning a Frenchman. A Frenchman said this, a Frenchman did that. Sir, I was wondering if this Frenchman could be Emile de Beck.
Yes, Miss Forbush, it is. I couldn't tell you before now, but as a matter of fact, if you wait here for a few minutes, you can hear his voice.
His voice? Where is he?
With Lieutenant Cable, behind enemy lines.
Behind enemy?
Hello. Hello, my friends and allies. My message today must be brief and sad. Lieutenant Cable, my friend Joe, died last night. He died from wounds in D.C. 3 days ago. I will never know a final man. I wish he could have told you the good news. The Japanese are pulling out, and there is great confusion. Our guess is that the enemy will try to evacuate troops from Cape Esperanza tonight. You may not hear from us for several days. We must move again. Two planes are overhead. They are looking for us, we believe them. What? Goodbye.
Is that all? Is that all? Can't you get them back?
No, sir, they're gone.
What would you okay? Captain Brackett? Is there a chance I'll ever see Emile de Beck again? And if there isn't, please tell me now, sir.
There's a chance. Of course there's a chance.
Didn't even know he was going.
Of course not. How could he tell you he was going? Now, don't blame Emile de Beck. He's okay. He's gonna be okay. He has got a chance, hasn't he, Bill?
Of course, there's always a chance.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Smarter every day. All right, all right. Stay prone, you! Vincent, you two! For heaven's sake, don't get spit out of
Miss McGregor. You don't get airsick, do you? I was wondering maybe if you had $3 handy, you could use this little package I got here. That's a female jerk! Beg your pardon, sir. May I have a word with you, sir?
Who's that?
Billis, sir. Luther Billis.
Oh, Billis, what are you doing, Blunt? We're moving out pretty soon.
Yes, sir, I know. I would like to do something for Miss Forbush, sir. Stewpot and the professor and me was wondering if anything was being done about rescuing that Frenchman off the island. We hereby volunteer for such a project, a triple diversionary activity, like I done to get him on there. You can drop us off in 3 rubber boats on 3 different sides of the island, confuse the hell out of the Japanese. Get the picture?
It's mighty fine of you, Billis.
Yeah.
But you're too late for any diversionary activity. That started this morning before the sun came up. Operation Alligator got underway. Landings were made on 14 Japanese held islands.
I think that's very unfair, sir. The first thing that he done was to save that Frenchman.
Well, the Admiral agrees with you, Billis. Marie Louise was the first island they hit.
Did they get him? Is he alive?
We don't know. Lieutenant Buzz Adams went there to find out, and he hasn't come back. But if the Frenchman's dead, it's unfair. We're too damn bad if a part of this huge operation couldn't have saved one of the two guys and made it all possible.
Could that be? As far as you can see, men waiting aboard ships. The whole picture of the South Pacific has changed. We're going the other way.
Captain Rack, sir, your launch is ready to take you to your ship.
You got a ship, sir?
Yes, Harrison and I have a ship. I'm no longer a lousy island commander. Come on, Bill.
Goodbye, Commander Harrison.
Goodbye, Billis. Oh, by the way, I never did get you to the brig, did I?
Nope.
I forgot.
Yeah, forgot what?
Your unit will be on our ship. I'll be seeing all of you. Get the picture?
All right, keep those trucks moving out. All units on Company Street, we're ready to load you in. Nurses to board assigned claims. All TVs to embark on carrier 6. Marines to board LCGs. Are there any questions? Move out.
Mind me and be nice to me, all right? I love you so much.